In today's KW command tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to use the KW command contacts export to view your contacts and what information is showing and what you're missing. This is a good way to go in and find out what information you need to be adding. So this question came in this morning from my KW Command with Lori Ballen Facebook group. We'd love to have you in there. So my name is Lori Ballen and I'm in Las Vegas, Nevada. I've got agents in Henderson, Boulder City, North Las Vegas, and I serve the Summerlin Las Vegas area. So let's go ahead and take a look at how we do this export. So up here, we're over here on the left, we're going to go to contacts. So this is where your export all is going to take place. Next, we're going to find the three dots up here next to contacts, and we're going to click export all contacts. Now you're going to get an alert that your export is being populated. And of course, depending on the size of your database, this is going to control how many contacts get exported. Then you're going to click on this little bell notification up here. It's going to tell you when your export is finished. So mine is not finished yet. We have something about compliance, so I'm going to dismiss that. Oh, there it is. Your full contacts export is complete. Tap to download. So let's go ahead and tap to download. We're going to do full contacts, and I will open it to show you how to look at that missing info. So we're going to go ahead and pop that open. It downloads in a CSV file. So yours should open in whatever your default program is, whether that's Excel or Numbers, whatever it might happen to be. Now, I like to work in Google Sheets myself. So what I will typically do is I'll select all, and then I'll copy this over to a Google Sheet, or I'll open the CSV file in a Google Sheet so that I can better work with my contacts, however, whatever you want to do. Now, let me show you the info that you can look at. So you'll be able to see names, obviously, and then you can look at country code, home phone number, mobile phone number, all of those information, emails, street addresses. So this would be a great way if you said, you know what, I've got my new send out card subscription and I'm going to send everybody a card that's in my database. So I need to go collect all their addresses. So maybe you're going to create a smart plan that has, hey, I've noticed in my database I don't have your current address and I'd like to remember you on special occasions or send you something. Could you please reply with your address or click this Google form so that I have some basic info? However you want to collect their address. Maybe you want to call them. Maybe you want to text them. I can tell you almost on a daily, not on a daily basis, that's way an exaggeration. On a regular basis, I get messages that say, hey, best address for you, and I send it to them. It's not a big deal. So this would be a good strategy to do, right? And then you can scroll over and you've got company and then you've got the company address. If you look up here in these are your sections up here. So key dates, birthday, home anniversary, what stage they're in the process, system tags, and then then you've got some other tags in here. Let me see what else. Notes. So if you've got notes, social media links. So this would be a good one to go through is to fill out your social media links. So what I've noticed in mine is that my custom fields are still not exporting, but this at the very least will allow you to see who's missing contact info to get your health score up, right? Phone numbers, date of birth, home anniversary, and addresses and social links. Those would be the key ones that I would start going through here to fill this out. And don't fill it out on your spreadsheet. Make sure you're looking up the contacts here and actually filling it up, filling them in on the record themselves. All right, hope that's helpful. I'm Lori Ballen in Las Vegas, Nevada.